Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Sydney. If you're new here and if you're not, then hey, welcome back. I'm here with my YouTube best friend, Kate. I'm visiting her in Florida right now. So if you didn't know, Kate is also a YouTuber, lives in Florida, just graduated. She's in digital marketing. I am a social media and digital content strategy / digital marketing student going into my senior year. And both of us have been doing YouTube for quite some time now. So we thought while we were hanging out together that we would do a little like tips for small YouTubers, things that we wish we would have known, and then also end it with some questions.
Yes, so I'm so excited. We've got a lot of good tips for you. We kind of condensed them into, I'd say, five tips.
Yeah.
Five like really good tips that maybe you haven't heard before, but it's stuff that Sydney and I talk about all the time.
So without further ado, let's get right into today's video. My first tip, you should start with purposeful, like, actual niche content before doing vlogs. And let me tell you why. So many people just see the vloggier world and they're like, oh, I want to do a vlog. Like, I'm just going to pick up the camera and film my day. And like, that's all great. But unless someone knows who you are, they're not going to look up a vlog. So like, let's say Kate just started out doing vlogs.
Yeah.
I would never know to Google Kate Ramsey vlog. You have to establish yourself in a certain category. So if you're in beauty or you're in fashion or you're in like kind of lifestyles, kind of like broad.
It's
but you could
very
do like
broad.
College. You could do a certain thing depending like that correlates to your job. Yeah, working from home. Like, hey, you could do some kind of travel, like something like that. Really establishing yourself in that and creating content first that's very searchable.
And everyone loves a good vlog. Like, I love watching vlogs, but Sydney's so right. I mean, you really need something of value to, you know,
to get your name out there.
Yeah, because then people will share that content. They're like, wow, that was so helpful.
Yeah, and like, correct me if I'm wrong, but you watch vlogs of someone that you already know of, correct?
Yes.
Like, you're not just gonna look up vlog on YouTube and then start watching it.
I've never done that.
So that is tip number one, and Kate is gonna go in with tip number two.
So tip number two is to use all the features on YouTube. This really just goes for any platform, whether it's Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, anything like that, but you should always be using every feature that they give you. So whether that is doing YouTube Lives, YouTube Shorts, that's their latest feature. Platforms are always pushing out their latest feature, so whether it's Instagram with Instagram Reels or something like that, but you always wanna be using everything. I mean, you should be doing, what's it called when you...
The community tour, or Premiere.
Premiere.
Premiere,
you
yeah.
Premiere. You can premiere your content. You don't have to do it for every video, but do it for some of them. That way you can interact with your audience before they begin watching,
yeah,
or interact with them while they're watching your video. And you can ask them questions and they can ask you questions and you can really interact with them. You should be using the community tab.
Yeah.
You know, notifying people, hey, these are the videos I'm going to be posting this week. Or,
yeah,
hey, we just hit a milestone. Thank you so much. And
you can use polls on the community tab,
oh,
like on the
so
comments
helpful.
And stuff. So I've done, which video would you rather see first? And then people will vote on it and things like that. And I kind of learned this in my marketing class, that you should be using those features. And when I learned about that, I started premiering my videos. And when I'm telling you, my views went way up. It's because within the first 10 minutes of your video being live, it's already had viewers because people are notified when you're premiering a video.
Yeah, they're notified like 30 minutes before. So they're like, oh, I should watch Kate's video in 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And you would normally have more people starting to watch your videos than if you would normally just post. So seriously, you should be repurposing all of your content. So whether you just made a vlog or a tips video or something, you can then take that footage, repurpose it in whatever, you know, editing software you're using, make it into a shorts content, you know, make it into that kind of a video. And then from there, if it's good for shorts, I mean, it's good for Instagram, it's good for TikTok, you can literally repost it and drive traffic to your video since you always want to be promoting your videos.
Yeah.
It's very helpful.
Tip number three is to make your title searchable. So this kind of goes along with the first tip that I had, but by this I mean using keywords in your titles that really draws people to click on your video. So for example, instead of just naming it vlog, maybe you could do work from home vlog or day in my life or college day in my life. Really finding description words that describe your channel. So for Kate, like, she's a digital marketer. She works from home.
Yeah.
She works a 9-to-5. She uses all those words in her titles, and maybe the video is just a simple work vlog. But instead of doing work vlog, she puts in digital marketing working from home, or
yes,
work from home with me, like, day in my life, 9-to-5 as a digital marketer. And it gives people something to search for rather than searching Kate Ramsey vlog.
Yeah, no one's gonna know who I am.
If someone's looking up, what does a digital marketer do? They might find Kate's video. Yeah. But if they're just looking up, what does a digital marketer do? And Kate has nothing to do with digital marketing in her title, they're never gonna find her. So using like brand names, for example, if you're doing a summer haul, put what brands that you got your clothes from. So like, for example, I just did one. I put H&M, I put Target, I put TJ Maxx in the title because maybe someone wants to look for recent products from TJ Maxx. They might type in TJ Maxx haul and your summer haul video will pop up.
Yeah.
But if you didn't put TJ Maxx in the title, they'll never find it.
I know, I've never ever searched like summer haul. I would always do like the brand, because I'm looking for like new clothes within that brand and what it looks like on real people and not just models.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so tip number four is to use TubeBuddy. If you don't have TubeBuddy, you can go, I think, probably look it up, TubeBuddy.com, download it to your website browser. I use Google Chrome.
Yeah, sure you too. Yep.
And it's like a little browser extension and it is the most helpful thing. And it really has helped my channel so much because it really is there for SEO help. So it helps you with tags. It'll help generate tags based on the title of your video. It will recommend tags that may do well, or you can add your own tags and it will actually let you know how good that tag is. Like, is there a lot of competition? Is there low competition? How many times is it being searched? Just like SEO friendly stuff like that. And it can really help you just create better tags to be found, you know, more frequently on YouTube. It also allows you to look at other creators and you can see what their tags are, which is kind of sneaky.
So sometimes it's funny because I'm like, they're using that tag and it's not even like really what their video is about, but it's getting them clicks.
Yeah. So you can look at other creators' tags and see what they have tagged and use those tags. If you're doing a video that's similar, you know, grab those tags or grab inspiration from what they're using. I think it's so helpful. I am forever like always like getting help from TubeBuddy. And yeah, just in general, it's a very helpful thing and it's so easy to use and it's safe as well.
Yeah, and that one that she's talking about, all those features are available in the free version, which is I have. I haven't
have
paid a single penny and it gives you all of that. So for example, if Kate just made like a summer morning routine vlog and I wanted to see what tag she's using because her video is doing really well, all I have to do is click on that video and the extension will open up on the side and it will show all the tags that Kate used. It will show how well her video is ranked in search. Yeah. Like all the info that you can see about your own content, you can also see about other people's content.
It's cool.
Yeah.
And it gives you a score out of 100 on how like good your SEO is and how well, I guess, your video is going to do with your title, your tags, like
description,
everything like that.
Okay, so moving on to tip number five, and then we'll answer a few of your questions. Number five is to foster a community around creating content. So that is the whole reason that Kate and I met. So I'm gonna go ahead and answer question number one for our Q&A. How did we meet? So, because this kind of tells the story of number five.
Yes.
But basically, March 2020, I was feeling very lonely because I couldn't be around my friends in person. And so I was like, why don't I just create this like little content group with like a bunch of girls that are content creators that are kind of my age, maybe doing the same kind of thing, same like size on their content, like their channel, and just kind of like really build this community that we can bounce ideas off of each other. Not like an engagement group, but do not join engagement groups. Not good. It's very bad and it makes you look like a robot.
Yeah. It is not good.
So that is not what I'm talking about here by community. What I'm talking about is like my friend Lily and I, we just went through both of our following and we're like, these girls like all look like they're in the same kind of like niche as us and they're creating content and they'd love to be in a group. So we messaged her. So I messaged Kate and I was like, hey, do you want to be in this group? And she was like, yeah.
Yeah.
And so that's how we kind of met, because since then, like both of us, I would say, are the closest in the group out of anyone. And like, we've really bounced ideas off of each other. We're constantly texting each other. Hey, which thumbnail do you like better? Which tag should I use in this? How did you do this on YouTube? And so creating a community like that not only allows you to bounce ideas off of each other, but it also allows you to have that support system that maybe you're not getting from your hometown. So like for me, I'm from a very small town. People looked at what I was doing a long time ago and they're like, why is this girl doing a YouTube channel? And I think that's why a lot of people are hesitant to start, because they're like, oh, no one will support me and I will be embarrassed and it'll be awkward around my friends and my family at home. But like with this community, I'm able to bounce these ideas and you don't feel stupid because someone knows what you're talking about. So
we've all been through it.
Yeah. And then you could also like do collabs. Like you could do, I know when I first created that group, my friend Lauren Doan and I, we did like a college busy day in our life. And like, we just tagged each other and mentioned that we were both doing those videos. We didn't even have to be together in person, but then people watching her video would be like, oh, Sydney created this video too. And they go over to my channel. So those are our 5 tips for a small YouTuber. I hope those really helped. If you have any more, definitely leave them down in the comments below, or you can message us both on Instagram. I will leave our links down below, but we're going to answer some really quick questions if I can find them on my phone. We already answered how we met. Tips for being consistent with a busy schedule. So Kate, I'm gonna let you do this because Kate's working 9 to 5 and she's the most consistent person I know on YouTube.
It can definitely be hard. So let me say that you're allowed to feel all of that. Like I feel like sometimes I feel really burnt out because I do work 40 hours a week. I then always post 3 videos a week on YouTube. I have a fiance, I'm planning a wedding. Like, I have a lot going on and I'm always traveling because my family lives, you know, very far away from me. So my biggest tip is Google Calendar. If you guys have seen any of my videos, I am a freak about Google Calendar.
Yeah, and she just posted a video about planning with her for June and it kind of goes over like how she plans for YouTube. So watch that.
it's helpful. But yeah, seriously, Google Calendar, if you just schedule your life in, you'll know exactly when you need to, when you want to post videos, when you need to actually film them.
That's the biggest thing I feel like, because I have an idea of when I want to post a video or when I want to post an Instagram post. But if I don't schedule in time to actually film it and like have time to edit, I don't do it.
Seriously, just go ahead and start planning when you want to film, when you want to upload, and just in general what you have going on in your day so you know exactly, hey, I'm gonna film this at 3. That's it.
And then another thing too is like brain dumping like video ideas. So once you brain dump all those ideas, then you're like, oh, I want to post a video on Mondays, but I have no ideas of videos to do. You can quickly go through and like, I like to separate them. So I do like sit down videos versus like vlogs. So like vlogs might be centered around what I'm doing. So obviously like I was vlogging when I was seeing Kate. I might not want to vlog at home, so I might pick a sit-down video when I get home to film and do that. So really just setting yourself up for success, I would say.
Yeah, is the biggest thing.
Okay, the next questions are, what are some misconceptions of being a YouTuber or a content creator? I think the biggest misconception is that you have to be living in this extravagant, like crazy life to be able to be a YouTuber or a content creator. But let me tell you, I live in the middle of nowhere and here I am. Like I create content and like, I don't know. I just feel like a lot of people think you have to be in the right place at the right time around the right people to do
it. Right college.
Or... Yeah, exactly. Like that you have to be going to this big university or that no one will watch your, I don't know, summer vlog if you're not on the beach, or no one will watch your college move-in vlog if you're not going to this big university. And that's so not true. And I think that a lot of people think that like when you start a YouTube channel that you have to have all these things lined up before you can do it. But in all honesty, like I say, fake it till you make it. It's not putting on a front. Like I'm not acting like I'm someone that I'm not. I'm just taking my circumstances and my situation and making the best of them.
Yeah, you're like romanticizing your life. I feel like anything looks good on camera. I feel like I've watched almost anyone do anything and you just don't have to live anywhere crazy. For me, it's like that YouTube is really easy. Like I feel like you see YouTubers and you look at them and go, oh, like I wish I just had like 1 million followers and that I could be making all this money. And yes, like they probably do make a decent amount of money. I mean, I'm really small. I only have almost 9K, but it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. And I don't think it really gets any easier. Even when you have a big following, it's like you still want to post videos. Otherwise people forget about you. You literally are everything. You're the planner. Yeah. You're the
director, the stage, the script.
The actress.
Yeah, the actress. Everything.
The editor.
Yeah, everything.
The marketer.
Yeah, for real. Like you're literally everything. So I think you're right. Like there's this misconception that people think, oh, all they do is just pick up the camera and then plug it into their computer and just post it. Like, that's so not true. Like, literally, we've been sitting here for, 18 minutes now, and this will probably take me, like, 4 times the amount of time to edit.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, the next one is, do you ever want to go big, like, being a big YouTuber? So this question kind of makes me feel all the feels. So if you would have asked me a few years ago, I would have been like, yes, I want to be huge on YouTube and I want to have this huge following, and that's what I want to do for the rest of my life. But slowly as I've grown up, I realized like that would be great, but there are also downsides to that. Like, you know, you're trying to cater to this audience and it's a lot of pressure that I think people don't realize. You know, do I post this video or do I post this kind of video? Do I just skip a day of posting so that way I can do this? Like, it controls a lot of your life. So I think it'd be really fun to be a big YouTuber. I don't think you can really plan on that unless you really, really work hard. But even then, like, sometimes it just doesn't happen and you have to realize that maybe it's not in the cards for me.
I swear it's all about luck, because I mean, we know so many people who have like all of a sudden like skyrocketed within the last year, and we genuinely are so like happy for them. But I feel like it really is all about luck and just the YouTube algorithm. And sometimes your videos just get promoted and sometimes they don't. But
you might be doing just as much work, putting in just as much work, maybe even more, and doing your research and doing all these tips from every single video you follow, and maybe it doesn't get picked up. And like that's really hard. So, you know, if it's in the cards, it's in the cards for me. I don't know. What would you say? Do you want to...
You know me. I would love to be a YouTuber full time. I feel like that's my ultimate goal. And I mean, we both are marketing people, but I mean, it's like part of my job is like social media and stuff like that. So to be able to do that full time would just be amazing.
Yeah.
I feel like, I don't know, maybe one day I would get sick of doing it full time and maybe I'd do it like part time and then work part time. But right now with me doing a full 9-to-5 and doing YouTube, of course I would love to just like be a big YouTuber.
Yeah, I think it would be so much fun, but we'll just wait and see.
They're big YouTubers. Subscribe. From all over.
Subscribe, please. And then the last question is, are you ever stressed out with being a content creator? So I'll answer this really quickly first. I would say, and we're very different on this because Kate is very consistent and I am very inconsistent. Like, I will go months without posting on YouTube.
But that's because you're in school.
Yeah, I'm in school and Instagram sometimes my thing. And I would say right now I am not stressed with being a content creator. The second that it becomes stressful or the second that it becomes like a job, I take a break. And maybe that's why I'm not growing as well as I'd want to on YouTube. But I don't want to be burnt out because ultimately, like, this is my passion. This is my passion project. And although I really do want to work hard at it, I never want it to seem like it's stressing me out or that it's taking away from my life or that it's making me, like, it seems more like a job or like a thing on my to-do list. So for me, no. But Kate might have a different answer.
For me, I feel like the only time I'm ever stressed out is honestly when I overthink things. And I don't know why, but I do tend to overthink. I think a lot of people do that. But it's like whenever you start overthinking and you're like, oh, I have to film tomorrow, and that's always on your brain, is I'm filming tomorrow. That means I have to edit. This means like all of this stuff. It's like, why are you stressing about that and making it a huge deal? Just pick up the camera tomorrow and just start it, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like that's the only time I ever get stressed, is that, or maybe if I have like a deadline coming up. But I feel like the majority of the time it's just me overthinking, and that stresses me out when I'm fine.
Yeah. And I feel like that's when I get burnt out too. Or like if I'm going through a season of burnout and like I've been at like a knoll for a while and then I try to like start again, my biggest thing is starting again. And I think it's because I think, oh, I have to edit, I have to film, which means I have to look good, and then I have to edit it, and then I have to get it posted. I have to get it posted. I don't either. And so I think I really do overthink it. And then when I start it, I'm like, wow, that was really easy. Like the vlog of us meeting literally was a little montage. It's already up. You should watch it. And then sat down for like an hour and finished the whole entire thing. Okay, so that is all. Dropped her phone. That is all for today's video. I hope you guys found these tips helpful. Be sure to subscribe to both of us. She has a video like this on her channel already, and we kind of pulled some of her tips to like do my tips because I forgot that she did this video until we were planning out the tips. But be sure to subscribe to us. It will really help us reach that big YouTuber dream. But also follow us on Instagram and DM us with any questions you have. We would love to talk about any of this stuff because it's something we're passionate about and we are willing to give you the secrets. We're not going to gatekeep in this little sisterhood that we have here. But thank you guys so much for watching today's video, and we will see you in the next one.
Go ahead and like her video and comment down below.
Yes, and go to Kate's video. We're filming something about my major and her job. So
exciting things.
We'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.